Hello, fiddlers! Welcome to day six. Today we're focusing on one of my favorite subjects, which is spot practicing. So spot practicing is when we go into a very specific area of a tune that is either giving us trouble or we want to clean it up in some way. So instead of going from beginning to the end of the song, we're going to go laser straight to the section that's either giving us trouble, like I said, or that we want to polish. So in The Hundred Pipers, the challenging section is the beginning where we have the double stops. And if you're not familiar with that term, a double stop is a chord. So the Hundred Pipers on the violin, we're trying to imitate the pipes. We're trying to sound like a bagpipe. So I'm having you play the A and the E string together. And if you haven't been doing it, if you've been playing the melody beautifully and clean, but without the double stop, I want you to challenge yourself because you can absolutely do it. And this is the best part of the song. So I'm going to have you place your bow on the A and the E string. And I don't know if you saw what I just did there, but I narrowed my focus in here to make sure that my bow was pressed up against the A and the E string perfectly. So that no matter how far I moved my bow, I got the A and the E string playing together at exactly the same time. So what am I talking about? I'm trying to focus on grabbing the chord, which is two strings at once, instead of hearing one note and then sliding into two. Or see the difference there? One is far more clean and a little bit more aggressive. So in imitating the bagpipes, when the bagpipes play, they have their melody, which they're playing on the chanter, and then their bags are holding a drone. So there's two notes working at the same time. And that's what we're doing. We're playing a melody on the A string, and we're dragging the E so that we have our chord, or it sounds like our bags. So here's what I would like you to do. I want you to move up a little bit higher on your bow from middle towards the upper middle. And I want you to really engage your pointer finger. So pointy finger, index finger, places pressure on the bow. So I'm going to get you to lean into that bow, add a little bit more weight, and grab the A and the E string together. If it sounds like you're creating a bit of a scratchy tone, or it doesn't sound good to you, extend your bow. Use more bow, because you can get this tone. I call it a fiddle fart, excuse my language. But if you get that grippy tone, use more bow and it will clean it up. See the difference? So here we go. Now I'm back to clean playing. Back to double stops. Back to clean. So one more time, I'm going to switch angles here because I want you to see how my stick comes down to the string when I play the double stop. Instead of, where I lose the chord. So I'm adding pressure from my first finger. Sorry, I'm blacking out here. There we go. So that is your homework for today. I was going to say this week, but for today. And that is the A section only. So you're not worrying about the B section, just the double stops, or the chord, as we call it, on the A section. All right. Come and let me know how you're doing. If you have a Facebook account, join us at modelfiddler.com. Sorry, Facebook. Join us at Facebook/modelfiddler. You can post a video or a comment. Otherwise, send me an email or let me know if you have any questions. We'll talk to you later. Bye.